find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh, check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you.
Hey, today's July 15th, 2014, and this is the Rambling Movie Minute, where we talk about everything movies from the week before, current, and yet still to come. I am the host, Mulango, live in Pittsburgh, and also in Pittsburgh is the great Sorgatron. How you doing, Sorg?
Just a little bit more than a long, arm's length away is us in the same region of Pittsburgh. Good to talk movies with you again there, Mulango. Although I saw just one this week.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. But what's the end of that?
I saw two, but one that just recently.
It's not a contest.
I know. It is a contest. Size matters.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
Is that Big Super 6? Is that it?
Big Hero 6.
Big Hero 6. I am sorry.
My new job is to be the Mulango corrector on this show.
I know one person that would definitely appreciate that.
I know a couple of people would probably appreciate that. I'll keep you in line, Mulango.
So the funny, interesting thing about that, I was reading a discussion on an article on that movie. And in the forums, somebody was upset. There are two points that people were upset about. The first one being that Marvel's name does not come up at all in this trailer.
Okay.
And apparently it's a Marvel comic strip originally. So I found that interesting. And then the second one, which I thought was kind of a funny argument, was the fact that somebody complained that Disney does not do any original art work anymore, like drawn animations, and everything now is CG.
Whoa.
In which case, I kind of wanted to reach through and kind of smack them.
But that's kind of what's happening. The 2D, the non-CG, is actually being used for like superhero movies and cartoons on networks and stuff. Nobody's putting in. It's hard to 3Dify and get that extra money off of a 2D flick like that. You know?
Yeah.
So I think that's definitely the biggest motivation.
So, but yeah, I think that's hilarious. I'm excited to see that movie, not knowing anything about the comic books.
No, I've never even heard about it going into this.
Yeah. So, and it's kind of like weirdly a little bit like Pokemon-ish and Power Rangers-ish, where I think they're like kids that, the description I read, it seemed like they were kids that were trying to defend a city, which surprisingly sounds like San Fran Tokyo, a combination of San Francisco and Tokyo. I thought that was funny. But yeah, I don't know. I'm very interested. I'm still kind of confused the direction that Pixar and Disney are going, because a lot of their films, even though Disney's taking a definitive style, with like Wreck-It Ralph and there's another one that they did that's very similar styles. Frozen. But even with those definitive styles, I still like the look. And I know that even though everything kind of falls under the John Lasseter umbrella now, I think the lines are blurred. There's no way that these people don't talk.
Yeah, you know? Isn't that great? Isn't that the influence you want, especially after their first couple of ventures, with CG, with the way Disney had been going in the animation department, and now you have, like, the guy is now filtering into this. I think it's, if they're doing a business culture share between Pixar and Disney Animation, it's nothing but good things. And I think we've seen the fruit of that with your Frozens, with your Wreck-It Ralphs, for instance.
Yeah, and I do like the fact that it's elevated the industry, because now you have people like DreamWorks that are saying, okay, we're going to elevate our game.
Oh, yeah.
And even though Rio wasn't the greatest thing, it still elevated its game in terms of like animation and lots of epic and very nice animated scenes. Mm-hmm. So that's definitely I think a progression.
I don't know if you noticed, I did pull up some artwork from Big Hero 6 again. Yeah. Never really seeing it before. It is a Marvel comic. I've really never heard of it, but it definitely has a little bit of, I'd say, Japanese kind of influence there, like you're talking about. And actually, there's pictures here with like characters like Sunspot. It looks like there's something with Guardians of the Galaxy, for instance. So, I mean, they're in the Marvel universe, so that's interesting for them to do.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's a funny way of Marvel to kind of sneak one in on us.
Mm-hmm. Good. if this is the kind of stuff we're going to get out of this new partnership, I love it.
Yeah, I know. Definitely. Bot's Office. We'll talk about Dawn of the Planet of the Apes of the No More Humans Anymore later, but they racked in a whopping $73 million. And Transformers dropped about 56% and pulled in about $16 million, which compared to their $100 million last, what was that, last week? I guess that was, it seems like a bigger drop than 56%.
Yeah, certainly. But it looks like Apes really kind of took off on that.
And Tammy is still scraping by.
Mike is cursing as he's listening to this episode.
that's really awesome. So this week, we're going to take like more of a discussionary role, which is something I wanted to start trying to get into. I don't necessarily want us to be a review show, mm-mm, but we do like our opinions if we have some to state. And in news, you know, if there's something that is interesting in the news that we would like to talk about, we like to talk about it just more in like a discussionary role. And eventually, you know, down the line, we open this up to other people and get some guests on here. But this week, the discussion that I wanted to bring up, Mike, was an interesting one on movies starting to take a quite definitive stance on certain topics, either gun control, animal rights. Dawn of the Dead played this up like crazy. And I noticed that trend, and I'm just wondering, like, is this kind of like where we're going?
Wait. What did Dawn of the Dead do?
Or not Dawn of the Dead. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
Oh, okay. Okay. That's a little different because I couldn't remember the big push in Dawn of the Dead.
No. More recently in movies like this. So a lot of the big discussions that, or kind of like arguments, is, you know, gun control and how that fares. And that came up in this movie a lot. Also, there was the implications of speciesism and how humans react to humans. Mm-hmm. And if it's really, you know, the fact that one person could kind of ruin it for a whole species type thing. But very interesting, I think, conversations that people were generally having. But I've noticed, like, has this happened in other movies? Like, I feel like maybe it could just be this director. And I should look and see what other movies this director has done.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, what's the one movie where it's like the last child is being born? Children of Men. Where that also played on like those very specific points of, like, you know, if we go the route we are, like, kind of weird stuff. But are you planning to see Dawn? Was this one of the ones that you had no interest in seeing?
No, not in the theater, at least. It's going to be a Netflix or something for me, or HBO or whatever it may come across. If you're wondering what this guy has also taken part in, the director from Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, I pulled up his bio here.
Mark.
He's been a writer on Felicity. The Under Siege 2, Dark Territory, Future Shock from the 90s. He's been a director on Area 51 Confidential. He had a thanks on Super 8, actually. I'm in the thanks and not the director. I'm sorry. Cloverfield he directed.
Yeah, I see that. Okay. Also, Let Me In. Wasn't that like a weird...
That was the kid vampire thing that I think he adapted from a Japanese movie.
So I don't think it's specific to this director. I think it's more specific to a genre. Like, I'd love to know what people think. Like, is this something that they're noticing in movies?
Well, what other movies are you noticing this in?
Well, speaking of,
notice it in Rapture-Palooza, for instance.
Well, but even Rapture-Palooza was still playing up on.
I guess there's a religious on thing.
That religious thing.
Yeah.
Well, one of the issues that, like, one of the reasons why I was even bringing up the question is I noticed a large amount of movies, and maybe this is us. Do you feel like we're becoming desensitized to human devastation in movies? Hence, like, the last Superman movie that we saw. Where mass genocide, also in Godzilla, where it's expected. Yes, you know, it's like there's this huge reptile dinosaur going through the city. Of course people are going to die. But they're almost like making it almost like a side note. In Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, they did not necessarily, like, we see human genocide. They go to war. But in that, we also kill off about millions of people in the span of maybe like a 30-second motion graphic, where it's just like, by the way, humanity's like gone.
And spoiler alert, that's what happens to Planet of the Apes. It's a remake. We can't really spoil that crap, okay? You kind of really know where it's going, right? We don't win, okay? I'm pretty sure.
We'll see.
I didn't see the movie. I'm pretty sure we don't win.
I will say, though, the way the movie ended...
Hold on a second. Yeah, spoiler zone. We don't win.
Oh, you ruined it for me, Mike. I haven't actually seen it yet. No, the way this movie is going, though, it makes me think, though, they might do a spin on... There's already been spins on this movie. But I don't know. It makes it seem like humans actually have a chance, which is interesting. Not in the second movie, but in maybe a progression of a third movie, we might still see humans in some form. Somebody brought up a good point that in one of the trailers, it actually shows a military convoy, as in the movie, there was not a military convoy. And I thought that's interesting, because maybe that's foreshadowing to the progression of the next movie. But I don't know. Like, I understand that in the grand scheme of things, these are just movies. And I do think they reflect what's going on in our society as a whole. But I don't know if that's necessarily reflections of a good thing, or if it's just...
You look at the Apes movies... much like zombie movies are always the reflection of society. Walking Dead, the people are worse than the zombies, you know. It's always been a place for them to take a stance on things. And the Planet of the Apes movies were, I think, supposed to be something similar. It's like what Star Trek was back in the day, right? It's something to make a statement, even though it was surrounded by science fiction. There's still, you know, a message in there, and a lot of things do. You could say the Batman movies are about, honor or something like that, and duty, right?
Yeah.
There's still a moral there, especially when it comes to these superhero movies, when there is a good versus evil sort of battle like that, you know?
Well, especially in the last Superman movie, where the clear, like, the line between good and evil and him making that decision, which they're claiming, that is his point from where his new moral compass has been set. It's kind of like, all right, well, because, like, here's a question: How to Train Your Dragon 2.
Yeah,
they dove into a lot of deep stuff, and that was a kid's movie.
Yeah.
You know? So
yeah, because we kind of lineage and responsibility, family responsibility, I guess, versus, you know, what happens when you get thrust into, you know, rising to the occasion, separated parents, you know.
And to be honest, like, I don't know, I seem to feel like it's a trend that's becoming more and more popular. Like, I didn't see Earth to Echo, but I have a feeling with it being like that, you know, comparison to E.T., the feeling that they're going to play up on that strong. They're using that generation. And then we got the next Hunger Games. The third Hunger Games was extremely political, if you have never read the books. So, I mean, I think that trend is continually going. Even Annie. If you see the Annie previews, like, that seems like there's just... But I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I mean, I think it's
interesting. Annie always was a statement, though, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, so, but you could see where they're, like, picking and choosing replacements in that storyline to keep up with the times. So it's like...
Interesting.
All right,
I thought I would see... I thought when they played the trailer for Annie in the theater, in public, I thought I would hear more rejection and groans, to be honest. I have no problem with it. But you see where some people can have problems with it, you know?
Yeah.
I'm still interested to see what my mom thinks of it, who loves the old Annie, right? So.
Yeah, no, I think it'll be very interesting. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think it's bold that we're going to have a black mayor. I mean, there's the joke that, yeah, Obama's here, so everything's changed. But right. Annie's clearly... black mayor and your black kid coming out who's now Annie from the slums with, like, I don't know, it's just interesting. But you know, with that being said, we still get our awesome, like, Godzilla no point to it, right, really, right. Movies.
Now
I guess that's good.
On the desensitizing side, and there were some comments, I'm not ignoring you, chat room, just getting around to you. Chachi's saying it's been like that since the beginning of the movies, talk about the death and everything. I think it's more to have to do with the lack of time in the movie more than desensitizing. I think it feels like a by the numbers thing that we destroy giant buildings and a lot of people die, right? We're far enough away from 9/11 where maybe people aren't as sensitive to that, right? But still, even sitting there watching, like, Man of Steel, I'm like, wow, it's a lot of fucking people that died, you know? It's,
Well, yeah, I think Man of Steel, there's a lot more cause for argument where Superman doesn't kill. Mm-hmm. And yet, you know, whenever we see Superman, he's always, like, saving the, you know, the cement block from killing the kid in the stroller or the ramp.
Right.
It's like...
But they scaled it up. They really blew out the scale on the first one, didn't they? As far as that flick goes. So it was like all destruction all the time on that thing. And then that's the Transformers movies, you know. I was reading an article today about how Spider-Man 3 may be questionable, but something like Transformers is consistently making more money movie to movie. And they're seeing a decline in something like Spider-Man. What does that say?
Yeah,
that's what people are going to, is the giant robot, holy crap, destruction movies. Pacific Rim, although I think Pacific Rim was a great movie, but it's giant robots destroying things.
But, even case in point, Pacific Rim somehow found a way that we knew that through the way that they described the plot of the story, we knew people had died. We knew, like, things were going bad, but they didn't stick it in our face, you know?
No. It was a very post-apocalyptic kind of thing. So you're like, hey, a lot of people died. It's really sad, and here's the story.
But, like I said, like, I don't know. Either way, like, it's one of those, like, I'd be interested to see what other directors do as we get... I feel like these movies are going to keep coming, and I do think it's... I don't know if it is necessarily a change of the times. It might just be that as we grow older, we start to realize some of this stuff.
And as it is easier for them to render a destroying building with little people falling out of it, 9/11 style, we get to see it more.
Do you feel like movies that relate more to the topics in hand that are going on with society tend to play up as better movies? Because you got to think that I feel like... can't think of the freaking name. The movie that's coming out, the big Marvel one, Guardians of the Galaxy. Of the Galaxy. And even with X-Men, like, I feel like those movies were actually better because they tied in to, I guess you could say, that emotional core, but, you know, that, like, human element almost, where it's like, yeah, we have more of a cause. Like, why do we love seeing, well, I enjoy seeing some sports movies because they play on that heartstring a bit.
It's accomplishment, you know. It's you could work and it's the American dream as far as that goes. As far as your sports movies, and I think the big thing with the, you know, X-Men, Guardians of the Galaxy, Marvel's always good about humanizing those characters. Versus like your Superman, it's like Superman. We can't have him just not punch things and fight an island again. So we need to turn it up. We can't make this believable anymore, or else it's going to be freaking ridiculous. So we're going to do what they did, you know?
Yeah. I mean, just look. So right now I'm looking on the coming soon.net, and they're previewing the next top four kind of movie previews. We got Batman vs. Superman. If they don't hit an emotional string, that movie's going to suck. Mm-hmm. I don't believe that. Not Matt Damon. What's his face?
Ben Affleck.
Ben Affleck. I don't really think that movie. I think is they're going up against so much competition with Marvel. You got The Hobbit 3, great story, but that's also kind of playing on our past. Like those have already come out, but they do a good job with that kind of like let me pull at some strings. You got The Hunger Games. If you haven't read the book for The Hunger Games, it's a good read. It's an easy read.
I'm hating that the previews are coming out and they're spoiling me for the second movie I haven't seen yet. That's my fault.
Yeah. Well, And then you got The Exodus, which is another Bible movie. But, I mean...
Oh.
That movie...
Wait. They're actually making an Exodus? Didn't I say, like, a couple weeks ago they should make an Exodus movie?
Oh, yeah, no, they are.
I was like,
there's
a bunch of other books. Let's tap into this shit.
Yeah, you said it like that. I called it a Noah movie, but they're calling it Exodus.
Okay. All right. Sure.
But I feel like the religious movies are kind of like, I'm not going to call them scapegoats. Like, if you, that is what it is. Like, if you make a bad one, and a lot of bad ones have been made, that's kind of your
you
fault.
You kind of have a low bar to begin with. You know,
I still held claims that Ridley Scott can do this movie no harm. If you haven't seen the trailer for this movie, go see it.
Check it out.
It looks freaking
awesome. Michael Bay starts doing, Book of Kings, I think I'm going to have a problem. But
when Michael Bay does Genesis,
Michael Bay's like, King Solomon. They didn't just split the baby. They split the baby.
It was a literal Big Bang.
Yes. I hope Bobby's listening, because he made a King Solomon joke on like the Mayhem show a couple weeks ago. Anyways, Chachi saying you are getting older, so you're realizing it more. It's always been there. I think in some cases not as effectively though, as far as the morality, just because I think storytelling has gotten a little easier, a little clearer, again, because of special effects and stuff, and more refined, you know. Go try to watch a movie from the early 80s or the 70s, and the pacing, oh my god, the pacing. It's horrible.
That's true.
Versus these days. And I'm not talking about, like, quick, action-y Michael Bay things. I'm talking about Robot and Frank, I thought had a good pacing, you know? It didn't feel like I'm like, oh my god, what's going on here, you know? So... I don't. That's my take on it. But we'll see. We'll see, Mulango. What else we got? Yeah, you watched a movie this weekend.
Yes, I did. I did watch Dawn of the Planet of the Apes of the No More Humans. Like I said, I enjoyed it. There's a lot of subtitles through it, which kind of caught me off guard.
Okay,
but that's I guess to be expected. Like I said in the discussion, I think it plays up. I like the kind of movie because it plays up on a lot of strong political points, kind of, and also like just the morality type things. I think it's very interesting that you have two or three specific characters that kind of determine the whole fate of their species. And as much as people want to aspire to do good, they're ultimately kind of doomed. But yes, I think it's a good movie. I know like a lot of people would probably go into it being skeptic. And with that, I would say go see it like matinee, you know, but it has a really good an interesting war scene. And the ape characters are rather compelling. Human characters, they don't totally live up, but I don't think they were as bad as some people are claiming they were. And then what else? What else did I see? Oh, I went and rewatched Ratatouille. And yes, that's a good movie.
I also noticed, I heard this on our show where they said that, is it Andy Serkis that plays Caesar? You know, he played Gollum and all that stuff, right? Actually got top billing on this movie. Like in the credits.
Oh, yeah. Like he was phenomenal as Caesar.
Mm-hmm.
Which
that really kind of, it elevates, I think, what he does, you know, as far as that CG placement character. Kind of thing, because he is doing the acting and he's not hidden under, you know, the mass of stardom that was Lord of the Rings, for instance. So that's pretty cool to see.
Yeah. What'd you watch?
I watched Rapture-Palooza.
Nice.
It was entertaining. It was one of those, you don't know what you want to watch? Well, I got something. Let's see how this goes. And it was fun. It was fun. I knew she'd watch it because it's got the guy from Bones in it, Sweets from Bones.
Yeah.
In a completely different kind of thing. And it's that goofball humor that we kind of dig in our movies. So,
the funny thing about that movie is I thought after a certain point they kind of just realized we have no idea how to truly end this movie. So, let's just go with it.
Yes, yes. If you're an atheist, you'll love this movie. Yeah. I'm pretty sure you'll love this movie. The representations are pretty good. If you go to church, you're gonna be fairly uncomfortable. But it was kind of fun. It was kind of fun. So good. Anything else?
No, I don't think I've been watching a lot of television stuff. I started watching a show called Motive. I don't even know what station it comes on, but it's kind of like a different twist on your cop drama. So I don't know if you're into like the quasi, give me a detective story in an hour and I'll figure it out.
Mm-hmm.
You might like that. And then another big one that I finished was Persons of Interest. I highly recommend that show.
Nice.
But the sad thing about that is I can't imagine how people were watching this week to week. Like I watched it straight through and it just clicked and it was so more engaging and like just great storyline. I guess like week to week, it's just, you know, kind of like, oh, what do people do before DVR?
And I think a lot of shows kind of suffer with that too, especially if there is a lot of detail. I also caught over the past week or so I ran through the entire Avengers Assemble series that came on Netflix, season nice. One. It looks like it more or less continues off Earth's Mightiest Heroes, not nearly as good, but I like that it's in the same universe as like Ultimate Spider-Man. A lot of callbacks to what's going on with that. It's good enough. It's a good Avengers series. It's just not on the level what Earth's Mightiest Heroes was. A lot of fun little stuff. You can tell they were like, hey, here's something that happened in the movie, so it'll be familiar to the kids. Like the guy from the first Thor movie, the big metal thing from that. Here's the Tesseract just because, you know? There's like a callback as if that movie did actually happen, but there's enough callbacks as if the first cartoon actually happened too. It's kind of weird as far as that goes, but you can kind of tell what they're doing. But, you know, they kept, I think, most of the soul of the original cartoon. So it's good to see. So
nice. Well, that's good. So real quick, the movie matchup for this weekend. I actually don't remember what it was. Oh, The Purge and Sex Tape and Planes, but that's not, I'm just going to write that off. So we got a comedy and a sequel. To be quite honest, I don't know what wins this one out. I am intrigued by The Purge. I saw the first one. But again, off our very funny conversation, yes, the government has allowed you for 24 hours to just kill. Murder is now legal.
It's just another one of those concepts they're going to slam into the ground that the teenagers are going to or something.
You think this is going to be like,
it's going to be Saw.
The lead into the Purge 6.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I could see the expansion, like the Purge World Tour. Yeah, it's honestly, what was it? You said it was Purge, Sex Tape, and Planes.
Well, I'm writing off Planes.
You're writing off Planes. I don't think you should. I honestly don't think you should.
I think I am, because like based on what happened on the first one, I don't think parents are going to make that mistake again to drag their kids out.
Yeah, but. It's they love Cars and they still love Cars, and this is basically Cars 4.
I would be surprised if Planes takes out Sex Tape. I think Sex Tape takes this one this week.
Going to get another one, another hot comedy for this year?
Yeah, I think you got Jason Segel there, you got Cameron Diaz. I think it's a funny idea. Everybody knows about, you know, the cloud. You know, that's a hot topic.
The millennials will get it, and they'll all come out for it.
So, yeah, I think that's the one I would go see this weekend. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I'd probably wait for The Purge to come out on Redbox or something. So, but, cool. So Mike, where can we find you?
I'm at Sorgatron on the Twitters. You can find all my stuff. Just start at MikeSorg.com or SorgatronMedia.com, and the bread comes, go out from there.
Nice. It's like a one-stop shop.
Mm-hmm.
I did do a comic review, which I Twittered, and I think I put it on the Facebook page. But if you don't know, we have a Facebook group called That Rambling Movie Minute. And you can check out my site where I do kind of like a bizarro-type, far-side-type comic strips based on the movies. They aren't reviews. They're more just random spins. So I'm trying not to. I've been told, Mike, that I spoil a lot of movies for people.
What? You?
I get so excited, so I just kind of blurt them out. So yeah, these comic strips will not ruin it for you. They're more intended if you've seen the movie, you'll get the joke. Maybe sometimes you don't get the joke, but they're more just like my crazy mind. But that can be found at thatramblingreview.com, where hopefully we'll also be posting up other stuff. Right, Mike? Maybe? At some point.
Sure. Yeah. Something.
So, yeah, definitely. Hit us up on our Facebook group page. Definitely link on to that, because we like to post questions and movie trailers and discussion notes. Let us know what you think about this format. If you'd rather us just talk about news and whatever opinions, or if you'd like to hear discussion points, and you know, that way people can get more involved, let us know what format you like. And yeah, I guess have a great movie weekend, and next week we'll ramble.